De keeper van Groningen. Die goede redding op rij, maar ja, dat is 4.
Geweldige redding.
Met z'n allen zijn ze gelijk zoals we het doen. Kijk, hey.
Ja, volle bak,
Yeah, I'm Sasha Matt and I'm 28 and I came from Austria. My father was goalkeeper as well, so I was born with gloves and I don't even was born and I had my first football shoes, so it was lying there and just waiting that I will be born. Then I went for football with 14 from home in a boarding school, and yeah, it was a tough time with a lot of learnings, but I made it then finally to Austria Vienna, what was my big goal. The main lesson was for sure if you work hard enough and have a goal, then you will reach it if you work every day on it, because that's what I did. So focused every day that I want to be there, and made a lot of extra work, and finally I reached it. And yeah, coaching got more and more and more. Then I got involved with Admira Wacker, which is also a Bundesliga club in Austria. And yeah, and then I made the big step to Red Bull Salzburg, which was really, really great. And there I could work with a lot of good goalkeeper coaches, especially with Hans Leitert and Stefan Loch, who both took me to side and teach me everything that I know now about goalkeeping. And yeah, it was a really, really, really good time there to learn and to grow as a person. The main part that I learned at Salzburg was goalkeeping is not just kicking balls and catching them. It's like way more. It's more about analysis. It's way more about not just technical, also tactical things, also psychology, a lot of psychology. And that was a big eye opener when I came there. If we do something on the pitch, there is a lot of preparation. And after the game, also a lot of analysis, or after the trainings. And we never do something on the pitch just to do something or just to kick some balls. There is always a sense behind it. I hope I'm trying to make these extra steps as well for the goalkeepers, to set them in a good environment where they can develop a lot. And I believe in that, that the game tells you what to do. So if you have a game situation and you break it down in the training session, then you deliver everything that you need for the game to be prepared. So that could be the psychological aspects, that could be the tactical aspects, this could even be the technical aspects, but also the mental stuff. So that's what we're trying to do, is to have a game situation and break it down and to have a session from that. We sometimes create an overload, that maybe the game is easier than the training session, but not in type of intensity. It's more mentally, more cognitive. And that's how we try to simulate the game. But of course, the game can never be replaced by a training session. So, I think we come very close to that. Of course, if you are a professional, you have to be an athlete, and you have to be in a big shape, in a good shape. But I think what is more important is that you're ready, that you're feeling good, that you have a good mindset, that you are not doubting when you go on the pitch. And I think that's the main job of a goalkeeper coach, to give that feeling, to reach that in a professional environment on the weekend, that your goalkeeper is prepared and feels good and have a good confidence to play the game. But of course, physical is an aspect, because it's not just okay looking good and looking good on the beach, but it can also be an advantage. But most of the time, it's for a goalkeeper to keep a high concentration over 90 minutes. And if you're not fit enough, then you can't keep that on a high level. Yeah, reaction time is a thing. I think it's more about deciding very fast, but not just fast, to make the right decisions as well. And that's what we keep a lot in our training sessions too. I really believe in, if you take extra steps and you want to really achieve something, then you have to do these extra steps. And if you make that, then you can achieve nearly everything.